It's that time of the year again for a new review of FamilyTreeDNA. Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, and this is a segment of DNA. Be sure to subscribe and click on the bell if you'd like to be notified of upcoming episodes. FamilyTreeDNA is the oldest commercial DNA testing company, and so they have a lot going for them. I'm going to give you three pros and three cons of what I like and don't like about FamilyTreeDNA. The first thing I like about FamilyTreeDNA is attaching DNA matches to your tree is super easy. All you need to do is click on the DNA matches in your tree view, and it's going to pop up the list of your matches. And then it's simply a matter of dragging and dropping over this person. It's going to pop up and say, what is this person's relationship to the person that you just dropped it on? And once you say whether this is their spouse, sibling, daughter, son, mother, father, you're done. And now that DNA is attached to that person on your tree. And so that makes it really easy to see how these different people are connected to you. And what it does when you do that, which is another bonus pro, is when you attach DNA to people on your family tree, it automatically calculates what their relationship to you is, whether that's fourth cousin twice removed or something as simple as aunt or uncle. The second thing that I like about FamilyTreeDNA is the not in common with search. Now, whenever you look at two people, you are going to share some matches in common. And those people are people you are likely commonly related to. And every website has a way to do a in common with search. But one of the things that FamilyTreeDNA has is a way to do a not in common with search. Now for that, what I can choose is I can choose one person and then click on the not in common with button. And it's going to pull up those matches who I have that the other person doesn't have. Where this is really useful, for instance, is let's say that you have your DNA and you have your mom's DNA, or somebody on your mom's side of the family's DNA. By comparing your DNA together, those matches are gonna be the people likely on your father's side of the family who don't share DNA in common with your mother. Now, this tool is really useful because not everybody has their parents and their grandparents all tested. And so in some cases, you need to do these negative searches to find those matches for the people that you want to research. The third thing that I like about FamilyTreeDNA is the fact that they have Y-DNA and mitochondrial DNA testing. This is actually where commercial DNA testing started, was with Y-DNA and then later mitochondrial DNA. Now, Y-DNA and mitochondrial DNA only follow your patrilineal line or your matrilineal line, but they are great tools if you have problems or questions on those lines, particularly if it is beyond the 5 to 7 generations that autosomal DNA is good for matching distant cousins. Now, not everything is perfect at FamilyTreeDNA, but it's not perfect at any company, so don't hold that against them. One of the things that I don't like about FamilyTreeDNA is that every single kit has a separate login. And by that, I mean, if I want to look at my kit and my wife's kit, I have to log out of my account and log into my wife's account. And so that makes it difficult because now I actually have to keep track of what the different kit numbers are and our passwords associated with each one of those kit numbers, as opposed to having a common login that I can view all of the kits that I manage at the same time. Now, number two that I don't like about FamilyTreeDNA is that when they are reporting their amount of shared DNA, they include all of their small segments down to 2 centimorgans and sometimes a little bit less than 2 centimorgans. Now, for your closely related relatives that are grandparents, parents, aunts, uncles, even cousins, first cousins, the amount of extra DNA that this is showing from adding those really small segments doesn't amount to much. And so the overall amount of shared DNA is roughly the same. However, once you get into more distant relatives, second, third, fourth, and fifth cousins, the amount of shared DNA that you have is really small, and so adding up all those small segments may be more than what a larger segment is. And by small segments, I mean things that are below about 7 centimorgans. Most companies disregard segments that are below about 7 centimorgans, whereas FamilyTreeDNA adds all of it together. And so when you're looking at your match list, people that you are matching 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, sometimes even 100 centimorgans myth may only be matched with you at 10 or 20 centimorgans if you were using a calculation more in line with what other companies use. Now, I have a video where I show you how you can take your match list and correct for this, but it would be nice if FamilyTreeDNA had a way that it would display it automatically and you could choose to display it with or without those segments. Now, the third thing that I don't like about FamilyTreeDNA is understanding, first off, that FamilyTreeDNA is not a genealogy company. They are a genetic genealogy company. And so they don't have record sets and they don't have a lot of the traditional things that some of the other companies have. But what they do allow you to do is they allow you to upload a GEDCOM file. And I already mentioned that I really like the ease it is to attach DNA to the different people on that GEDCOM file. Unfortunately, unless you are only keeping track of your family lines within FamilyTree, you're probably using some other program, in which case you're periodically going to want to upgrade that GEDCOM file to the latest information. Now watch what happens when I go and click on upload a GEDCOM. It's going to tell me it's going to overwrite everything that I already have there, which means all of my DNA matches that I've already identified are going to be lost. And that's unfortunate. And so it would be nice if there was a way that you could actually merge that GEDCOM file with what you've done previously so that the same people become the same people and it really only adds new information and preserves all of those DNA matches that you've already put on to your family tree. So that is my three pros and my three cons with FamilyTreeDNA. I still love FamilyTreeDNA and I use them in a lot of research. I would recommend them to anybody who is interested in doing some genetic genealogy. And if you have any questions about FamilyTreeDNA, put it in the comments below and I'll try to answer it. And if you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and tell your friends all about it.